Okay, we should be live. Gonna be moving that off the side. Yep. Hello. I'm streaming, kitty. Go away. No. What is... Oh, there it is. Headphones or surround sound strongly recommended for maximum enjoyment. Well, I'm already got headphones on. Meant to do this earlier, but I didn't know what game I wanted to play. Tons of bullshit here, blah 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 blah. Alright. Play the main campaign, a voyage of emotion and discovery. I'll tell you what emotion I'm experiencing right now. Mild irritation because my cat won't leave me alone. Yeah, that's right, kitty. Effects mode, challenge various modes to match your current mood. Enjoy cooperative or competitive Tetris locally or online. Adjust various settings, view tutorials, and more. No, I did not get Metroid yet. I do have it ordered. It is currently in the process of being in transit to me. The problem is that I'm not gonna get it. Cat, don't freaking... All right, come on. The problem is that I'm not going to get Metroid any earlier than Monday at earliest. So. Explore the outer reaches of the galaxy to the depths of your soul. Complete journey mode on any difficulty, and would you like to view the basics tutorial? You know what? Fuck it, let's go ahead and go over the tutorial. These descending blocks are called tetraminos. Once they land and stop moving, they become blocks. Maneuver following tetraminos to create complex rows of blocks. These are called lines, and they disappear in exchange for points. If they stack up to the top of the playfield, the game is over. Move tetraminos left and right using the directional buttons. Press A to rotate them clockwise or B for counterclockwise. Use the down button to force them to fall faster. This is called a soft drop. The up button will immediately drop them down as far as they can go, known as a hard drop. L or R moves a tetramino to the hold queue. Pressing it again will swap a tetramino in play for one in the hold queue. By default, the left stick zooms the camera in and out, and the right stick rotates the camera. Ooh, that's different. The zone is an all-new mechanic designed just for Tetris Effect. This is how it works. Fill the zone meter by clearing lines, and then press ZL or ZR to enter the zone. Tetraminos stop falling, and completed lines move to the bottom of the play field. Once the meter is empty or a tetramino reaches the top of the playfield, you'll exit the zone and get a special bonus for all lines you've completed. Additional bonuses can be entered by entering the zone with a full meter and clearing more than 8 lines before exiting the zone. Interesting. Alright. So we got normal, standard difficulty recommended for most players. Beginner, which is an easier difficulty for novices or players feeling rusty, and expert, more challenging for skilled players. Let's go with the normal. I mean, I'm not that super great at it, but I mean, this is freaking Tetris. How super difficult can this be, huh? Yo, am I tripping, or is this Super Mario Galaxy music I'm hearing? Feels a lot like Super Mario Galaxy music somehow. I'm probably just tripping again. Oh, back-to-back Tetris. Oops. Well, fuck that up. Save that. Yo, I hope this music ain't copyrighted. Just taking a look over at the chat and messed that up. Oh well. That's fine. We're not doing too bad. And that's easily fixed anyway, so. We're still going. People have been nuts on copyright recently. Vanamelon recently did a reaction vid that had copyrighted music, so she used a 15-second 8-bit cover and still got copyright struck. So she just replaced it with her humming it and singing made-up lyrics about how stupid, about how weird the copyright hit was. God diggity damn, ouch. That is such bullshit. I mean, copywriting is such just. I mean, I get what people are doing in terms of trying to, you know, make sure that they don't violate copyright idea or what have you. But, I mean, come on, people. I'm not gonna lie, the whole copyright thing, the main reason I'm concerned about it is because I just don't wanna lose out on people, you know, wanting to enjoy my content. I mean, I'm not getting paid for any of this, so, well, I mean, what do I care? Thinking back to that one person back on that one channel who was complaining about how bad I was at Tetris and that my playing caused them physical pain. I'm like, okay, well, motherfucker, if my playing causes you physical pain, then fucking stop watching. I mean, you don't have to be here. You don't have to watch. Goddamn. I think I aired. Oh well. Easily fixed. Oh neat! I just realized. Changing the orientation of the Tetraminos causes the beat. That's pretty wicked, actually. Ah, oh, damn it. Fuck. Fuck that up. That's just too fun, I'm sorry. You know what? I just realized we have enough, I believe we have enough of that power to go into the zone. Oh yeah. B-rank, not bad. I mean, I wasn't exactly going for something super. But we leveled up to level 5, Journey Mode, Music Area 1. Oh, so that was all. Ooh, interesting. So So, oh, interesting. Okay, so that goes into the deep. Then there's the Pharaoh's Code. Oh, so then this goes. Oh, okay, so that. So then this area has four segments. That area has four. This area has five. So we got one, two, three, four, five, six. So six areas, and then the what looks to be a final stage for Journey. All right, that's fair enough. I think we can handle that. Let's zoom in a bit. I'm really liking the aesthetics on this. Not just on the visuals, but like how this is reacting to the music. If I go silent, it's mainly because I'm trying to focus on this. Because I can't really focus on gameplay and providing decent commentary at the same time. I mean, if anyone's really gotten super focused on a high-speed game of Tetris, you'll know what I'm talking about. Done. Let's see what this is all about. Ooh. Oh, that's a neat aesthetic.
crap!
Didn't need to do that. I don't like this. Okay. Crap. And the Nile. Fat-fingering this somehow. Line piece. Ask and ye shall receive. Oof. Still in this, we're still in this. We can fix this. Not if we fuck that up though. Okay. I just realized something. If I fail, am I gonna have to restart the whole thing from the first stage, or? Does this act as a checkpoint? That's what I want to know. Kinda hard to determine what's the actual block and what isn't. Uh-oh. This. B rank, hell yeah. Area 3 unlocked. So yeah, area 3, area 4, area 5, and area 6 to go with final stage after that. I think we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna bounce out of the journey mode for right now. We'll try and take a look at effect mode. Welcome to the Effect Mode staging area. Here you can see what the Tetris Effect community is up to. Once you select where you're from, you'll see friends and other players' avatars and levels. When you're ready, choose play to see a list of modes to choose from. So yeah, we're United States. I'm assuming that's, yeah, it's Hawaii right there. All of these, it's just Africa. Well, I'm going to assume that This is the approximate area of where I am. Help the community meet its goal before time runs out. This week's theme is adventurous. Life is either a daring adventure or nothing at all. Okay. And why does it say Mr. Binge JPN right next to where I'm at? That doesn't make any sense. Also, I don't think that's anywhere close to where I'm actually at, but that's fine. I guess it's... Oh, yeah. Oh, we could change that. Okay, that's fine. So... Current avatar is a fish! Oh. Okay. So we got countdown, purify, mystery, marathon, ultra, sprint, master, chill marathon, quick play, and playlists. Submerge yourself in four aquatic stages with relaxing ambient music. Falling LI Tetris News to earn the best score you can within 5 minutes. Clear as many dark blocks as you can within 3 minutes. Try to survive some random effects keep popping up. And get the best score you can within 150 line limit. Interesting, okay. Insanely fast Tetris, not for the faint of heart. Yeah, but fuck that, I ain't doing that. Yeah, play a more relaxed version of Marathon with no game over. Play any single stage you choose with no game over. Alright. Alright, well let's do this. We'll do a couple of these and... See what's going on. Hang on, let's start over. I see what's going on here. Oh, okay, so. I see what's going on, okay. Very intriguing. Thank you. crap. Well, that kind of just went horribly wrong in the end, but... Planet Avatar unlocked. Neat. As many dark blocks as you can within 3 minutes. Oh, I get it. This is kind of like the Tetris B mode from the original NES. 190 clears. Ah, the first non-B rank I've gotten thus far. Yeah, that wasn't too great. But I did level up, and I got a new avatar for the... let's see. I want to use this Karma Wheel one. I like this one. Survive the random effects, clear 150 lines. No ghost, huh? Whoa. Horizontal. Ooh. What the hell is that all about? Diamond. Oh, I see. Oh, and the whole item can't swap with anything held. That's kind of mean. Oh, what the fuck is this bullshit? Thank you. Okay, at least it's only just in regards... ...to the playing field and not the actual controls. What the? What? Okay. Damn. Okay. That's crazy. I was like thinking to myself, well, it's not too bad. The horizontal one wasn't too bad. Then they slapped me upside the head with the vertical one. I was like, oh, geez, okay. If it hadn't been for that vertical one, I probably would have done a little bit better, but oof. Alright, let's jump into a little bit of multiplayer and see how that does. A mysterious moon has appeared in the multiplayer galaxy. During the 24 hours of the weekly full moon, you can play connected versus. Will you uphold your vow as a guardian or taste the dark side and play as a Zodiac boss? More community bullshit to have to agree to. Alright. So, cross-platform play is on by default, so multiplayer may include players from other platforms. Hell yeah. I'll be more than happy to do that. Welcome, Guardian! Welcome to a galaxy full of wonder and horror, victory and defeat, challenges without and within, and of course, lots of Tetris. A negative void threatens to erase all of existence. Already, its dark influence has corrupted the constellations, pitting them against the spirits of you and your fellow guardians. Band together with friends and strangers across the world in connected mode, and show these stellar zodiac bosses who's boss. In multiplayer, your tier indicates your overall experience and ability. Which tier you fall into is based on your aggregate of your skill rating in the different modes, which increase when you run ranked matches and decrease when you lose. You're also separately rewarded a little bit each time you play, so get out there and grind. As you move up the tiers, you'll move ever closer to the mysterious obelisk radiating in the center of the galaxy, the Tetramedion. I don't even know if that's how that's the proper pronunciation, but legend has it that awaits a wonder sanctuary that only the most worthy may enter. Diligence and practice will pave the way to the Tetramedion. Prove yourself worthy. Okay, so we can go ahead and fly around, check out avatars. We can see avatars we've unlocked and change which ones we may use. Let's see, match types. In ranked matches, you'll be match made with players close to your skill level. Friend matches let you create a private match that you can invite friends to join. Local matches are offline games you can play with others on your same system, so basically couch co-op. Alright. Sure. Let's go ahead and jump into a ranked match. There are four main competitive and cooperative game modes. A quick introduction for each will follow, but check out the individual guides in the tutorial menu for more details. So connected is form a three-player team to try and defeat the AI-controlled boss. Connect your matrices as you all enter the zone and clear lines together to deal massive damage. Zone battles are one-on-one competitions played with standard Tetris Effect rules. The key to victory is adept use of the zone mechanic. This is a great way to test out the skills you've built in the single player. Another one-on-one competition is the score attack with standard Tetris Effect rules, only this time no line attacks are being exchanged. If your score is higher, you win. Pretty straightforward. And then finally, classic score attack, one-on-one competition using classic Tetris settings. like no hold Q, no hard drop, quick lockdown, which makes it much harder than Tetris Effect. So that looks like just standard old classic NES Tetris. Alright. Yeah, too bad he is. Alright, that's fair enough. Let's go ahead and do connected versus. Soiching. Unable to connect. What? Ah, bullshit. Alright. Alright, so I'm on. I guess I must have been disconnected. Well, okay then. Rather than proper shut. All right. Let's try that one more time and Alright, match begins. Because I want to do at least one match. Barely use a line piece right about now. Ugh. Hell yeah. High fives all around. Skill rate adjustments are calculated changes as you play the game. For example, those with few total matches will see bigger increases and decreases in their SR. Okay. Unable to continue with the session because your connection with the opponent was lost, but you have achieved Tier 2 status. You're now a Guardian Infantry, and the Infantry Avatar has been unlocked. Let this serve as a testament to your efforts. You're just getting started. Neat. Galaxy suffers under the threat of 12 constellations, all corrupted into nefarious zodiac bosses. Only by working together with the Guardians will have any hope of defeating them. Okay. Vanquish 3 pushover AI bosses one after the other. Sagittarius, Pisces, and Taurus. Alright. Just gonna wait for a couple of extra players, assuming we're going to get any extra players. Well, it looks like we got one. So, how's everyone doing tonight? All right, match begins in 3, 2, 1, let's go. Oh, I see. So this is... Thank you. I could have went a little bit better, but I think we did pretty well. I cleared the least amount of lines, but I contributed most of the meter, I guess. Oh, and it's still going. second guy down. Most lines cleared, and well, not the second most. Meter contribution. So we got. Oops. Hell yeah. GG team. second most amount of lines, with the least amount of meter contribution. You know what? Fuck it. We're doing pretty good with this team. Let's keep it rolling. Oh, that's not good. Thank you. Things are getting a little bit harder here. Oh, crap. Doesn't help that I am getting a little tired. I think what I'll do is I'll finish up with this section here. Looking pretty good with my team though, it looks like. Crap. Don't know if my yawning's coming through the microphone or not, but... Alright, and then this should be... the last one. That is... Again. We'll be right back. Hell yeah. Cab! Fill the next avatar gauge by playing matches. Clear area 2 in connected mode. Host chose to exit so the session is closed. Yep. Sorry, boys. I think that we're going to go ahead and we're going to call that for right now. It's only been about a 90-minute stream, but I was only wanting to do a short stream tonight as it was anyway, predominantly because I kind of wanted to just see if the stream key for OBS was now working, and wanted to make sure that connecting my Twitch account with OBS was going to work. And that seemed to do that just fine, so I think I'm going to go ahead and call this here for now. And I guess I'll catch you guys later whenever I stream next. And who knows when that's going to be. All right, guys, I will catch you guys then. Later.